Happy New Year, everyone. Welcome to 2021. And maybe this morning you woke up and you're a little bit dehydrated. I don't know. Maybe you had a Bloody Mary. I had coffee and then hydrating with some Gatorade. Makes life a lot easier. But Happy New Year. And once again, it's that time of year when we all start with the, all the resolutions. What is your resolution going to be this year? Did you have a resolution that you're going to lose weight? You're going to eat better. You're not going to drink as much. You're going to do more fishing. You're going to spend more time with the family. You're going to go on a road trip. What are you going to do? What was your resolution this year on what you wanted to do? I just want to point out one thing real quick. I notice a lot of people have made comments on my videos about me wearing all my Ron John gear. Okay? I love Ron John. I have probably 20 different types of shirts and everything else. And I love them. Okay? I live in them. I live in Florida. Ron John's is probably 10, 15 minutes from my house. So that's my favorite little man store that's close by. I like to go in there. I love shopping in there. I buy all their shirts and everything else. But today, because it's a new year, 2021, I am sporting Pink Floyd. As you can see, one of my favorite number one bands. So, for all you out there you go. Something different, starting off the year in 2021. Especially if there's any new preppers out there that are watching this video, and maybe some of you older preppers. Maybe this is a good year to start the year off with a bang and start getting prepared for whatever may come in 2021 that we're all just waiting to see, for all the fun, the excitement, whatever it may be. Because if you're prepared, you really don't have to worry about anything coming your way. That's the whole key to being prepared. The whole key to being prepared is so that you don't have to worry. Period. The first thing that you probably should do is make a resolution that you're going to make a plan. You're going to make a plan for you and your family on emergency situations, whether it's evacuation plan, whatever it may be. And put that plan together and actually implement it. Follow up with it. Whatever your plan may be, make sure it's stocked up and you have all the supplies and everything that you do need. You know? Sorry, I got a little dry throat this morning. But anyways, the whole key to this whole prepping thing isn't so that you're looking like you're some type of a hoarder or something like that. Okay? Now, if you had like 10 years worth of food or something, maybe you could be considered a little bit of a hoarder. But then again, you're also prepared. What I'm talking about is at least having a basic 2-week supply plan in place in case of any type of an emergency. And we could list them all off, but I've already done that before. So it's a new year. And some of you are already starting to get your $600 stimulus checks down. Hey, spend it wisely. So that's why I say it could be a good idea for some people. Now, there are people out there that need that money to pay rent and maybe put food on their table right now. But there's also everybody out there that really, that's just extra money in the bank. So instead of leaving the money in the bank, take that money. If you do not already have a plan or an emergency backup of your food, water supplies, and implement it. It's found money. You didn't have to work for it. Well, actually, you did work for it because it's a taxpayer's money. But it's not like you put in extra hours at work or something like that and, you know, you got some extra cash and you had to save it up. you got a one-time deal shot of $600, and you can really stock up and be prepared for $600. You probably could do it for half the price if you're wise, frugal, and do your homework on who has sales and who doesn't. Put the other $300 into buying some emergency backup supplies, equipment, maybe a battery bank, maybe some solar chargers, that type of stuff. Stuff to get you through a situation where is if you don't have power, you don't have water, some way maybe to filter water out, you can buy something for as little as under $20. So, what are you going to do with your $600 you just got? What is your resolution going to be? I think, you know, typically speaking, in a sense, most people set, you know, their New Year's resolution as, you know, I'm going to lose weight, I'm going to eat better, I'm going to work out more, all this type of stuff. When in reality, you might do it for a week or two. You know, you go out and you spend, you know, say you take that $600, you go out and buy yourself a piece of gym equipment. All right. Now, I know for a fact, because I was one of those people years ago, okay, I'm Generation X, so anybody out there, you can kind of figure out how old I am, and I'm more towards the beginning of Generation X, not the end. And I bought a piece of gym equipment 1 year with my tax money, okay? Now, this is back when I was like 20 years old. So I bought that gym equipment. Ah, yeah, I'm going to work out every day and everything else. Well, guess what? That didn't happen. I worked out for the first couple of weeks, and the next thing you knew, I was using it for something to hang my clothes on. It's a fact. It's probably one of the biggest things that people waste money on is gym equipment at this time of the year. Now, yes, there are folks that will utilize that equipment and put it to good use. And kudos to you for staying healthy and trying to maintain a nice, fine six-pack. But in all reality, you're just wasting your money. So if you take and put that money and put it into, well, you know, some survival products for you and your family to ensure that you and your family, hey, are ready and prepared for no matter what comes out of 2021, if you got a 2 week backup, that's a great start, folks. A great start. And like I said, if you did your homework, you probably could do it for about $300. And you could buy some really good stuff. So this is Survival Preparedness for Beginners. And my name is Charles. I've had a few people ask what my name is. There you go. But I wanted to bring you a little something on New Year's Day, just to say Happy New Year's and to get you thinking about what you really need as a New Year's resolution and what you really want to spend maybe your $600 on. Just saying, folks. So until next time, I hope that everyone out there had a great New Year's Eve, and I hope and pray that 2021 is better than what 2020 was. Because we all know how that one went. I even stayed up to midnight last night. First time since 2000. And I stayed up in 2000 just because I wanted to see if everything was going to crash, like they said. And that didn't happen either, did it? So, hope you're all doing well. Hope not too many of you got a hangover. And if you do, well, you know. Bloody Marys, lots of liquids. You'll be just fine come tomorrow. Lay on the couch. Watch my video. Till next time. I'm Survival Preparedness for Beginners, and I'll catch you all on the flip side.